Let's bring in Tom Homan, Fox News contributor, former acting ICE director. Tom, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We've been hearing from Griff Jenkins, who has talked to the Department of Homeland Security, and apparently this planning profile looks at what the forecasts are. And right now, the number of families trying to get into this country is, they're suggesting that in this year alone, it will eclipse the last 3 years combined. Why are so many families heading north?
Because there's no consequence. There's no deterrence. Congress hasn't closed the loopholes that, you know, entice them to come. Look, the families can't be detained more than 20 days, and that's not time enough to see a judge. They know that. So they'll come, they'll be detained a few days and get released. If you look at the numbers of families from Central America, look at the data on the books now, 92% of Central Americans that claim asylum at the border will not get relief from the government because either they don't show up in court, they don't file in court, or they lose their cases. So until Congress closes that loophole, you're going to see them coming, which is why I said last week, ICE, I think ICE needs to do a nationwide operation. They need to look for these family groups and adults who have had their due process at great taxpayer expense and been ordered removed by a judge. We got to execute those orders because if we don't, if those orders mean nothing, there's no integrity in the entire system. I did that 3 years ago, and it resulted in almost immediate decrease in illegal crossings on the border. We have to show Central America we're serious about enforcing our laws.
So you don't need Congress for that. Kirstjen Nielsen decide that ICE is going to be empowered to do that?
Well, they don't have to be empowered. I mean, it's their job to locate. Look, ICE has to, again, they got to prioritize the criminals. I get it. I did when I was director. But in FY15, when this 15 and 16, when this was out of control, I took it upon myself to say, look, I got to go arrest these people that have been ordered removed by a federal judge. That's my job. We spent a lot of money. You know, Democrats stood on the border in San Diego, says they have a right to claim asylum. They have a right to see a judge. Okay. We'll do that, but once they see a judge and get that final order removal from a federal judge, we need to execute it. So ICE can certainly make the decision. The department would have to support it, but we did it. I did it, and it worked.
What do you make of the left claiming that people are dying in custody at the border under the Trump administration?
Two children died in Border Patrol custody, and, you know, let's be honest, it's a terrible tragedy, but first of all, you got to blame the parents for dragging their children 1,000 miles through the desert. The Border Patrol agents did everything they could to save these children. The left doesn't talk about the 4,000 people that Border Patrol saved that were in dire straits when they were found in the desert. They don't talk about that. But if you look at the numbers, when I spent 9 years at ICE headquarters before I just recently retired, and we averaged between 9 to 12 deaths in custody. But we have 350,000 people from third world countries who many have never seen a doctor come into our custody, so they're in bad shape. It's unfortunate anybody dies, but 9 to 12... it's a pretty good number if you compare it to New York State. Now, AOC, she likes to yell about people dying in ICE custody. Her own state has three times as many deaths in custody, and they deal with 90,000 people as ICE does. We got one-third the deaths with a lot more people coming through our process. When I was the director of ICE, we spent $500 million on medical care for illegal aliens. So the numbers are, I think the numbers are they're sad, but I think our medical program in ICE is better. We have less deaths in name a state penal institution, any other detention program. We beat most of them.
All right. That is on our southern border. And yet, Tom, watch this. Here's a bit of an NBC News report that says, don't just worry about our southern border. Worry about Canada. Watch.
It's here in Vermont where we joined U.S. Customs and Border Protection to best understand why an increasing number of migrants come to Canada to enter the U.S. illegally. All Mexican nationals need is a $300 airline ticket and a $7 Canadian entry fee.
Does Canada make things more difficult for you because it's so simple for somebody from Mexico to fly to Canada without the need of a visa?
It's definitely an area that can be exploited.
While the raw numbers are small compared to the southern border, new government statistics illustrate a trend, a 91% increase in the number of undocumented migrants captured along the U.S.-Canada border, a 232% increase on the icy, treacherous Vermont-Quebec border.
Okay, a lot of people don't realize that. Tom, how big a problem is that?
Well, look, it's a problem. When I was the ICE director, I actually took a northern border tour, and I took a helicopter ride from Vermont about midway in New York. I grew up in that area. So look, during the winter time, people can walk across the river, take a snowmobile across the river. And up in Thousand Islands, you can get on a boat and be from Canada to Gananoque to to the United States in 30 seconds. It's a problem, but we got to look at the numbers. What the northern border arrests in a year, southwest border is arresting in a week. So it's like anything else. If you got a bunch of holes in the dam, you got to plug that biggest hole first that's letting the most water in. That's the southwest border. But Border Patrol recognizes numbers on the northern border have increased. So did Iowa's director. I assigned more special agents up there, more assets to work with the local and state. We have great working relationship with the Royal Canadian Mounted Police. We attack smuggling together. Border Patrol has increased assets and technology on the northern border. So it's a problem that's being addressed. But again, the biggest problem is way south.
Yeah, no question. I just wish that both sides can realize there's a problem that needs to be addressed yesterday. It seems like the Democrats are just ignoring it, and these numbers don't lie. There's no political angle to these numbers.
Look, you're exactly right, Brian. And look, I've said it many times. The Democrats, even though I'm very disappointed in Democratic leadership, they're not that stupid. They don't know the numbers aren't real and we got a problem. This is all about political stance against this president. If the president fixes the border issue, that is terrible for them in 2020. This is about resisting and hating this president more than taking their responsibility to secure their border. They know there's a problem. You can't deny there's a problem. They're smart people.
Yep.
All right. Thank you, Tom. Good to see you.
Good to see you.